हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ यूनिट 1 ऑफ क्लास 11 एनसीईआरटी केमिस्ट्री बुक। एंड दिस यूनिट डील्स विद सम बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ केमिस्ट्री। एंड टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ केमिस्ट्री एंड इट्स डेफिनेशन। So, if we have to define chemistry, then in simple words, we can say chemistry is a science of matter and its transformation from one form to another. This is the simplest definition of chemistry. And chemistry deals with the composition, structure, properties, and interaction of matter. And to understand these aspects, we have to understand about basic constituents of matter, which are atoms and molecules. So we can say that chemistry is the science of atoms and molecules. Roald Hoffman, which is a Nobel Prize winner in chemistry, he has defined chemistry as the science of molecules and their transformations. He says it is a science not so much of 100 elements, but of infinite variety of molecules that may be built from them. So, if we look around ourselves, chemistry is involved everywhere. Sun gives us light and heat, which is essential for the existence of life on Earth. But the light and heat produced by sun are because of a chemical reaction called nuclear fusion taking place inside the sun. Similarly, production of food by photosynthesis, this is also a chemical reaction in which, in the presence of sunlight, carbon dioxide and water, they react to give you glucose. And photosynthesis is also responsible for the existence of life. If there had been no photosynthesis, there had been no life, and photosynthesis is a chemical reaction. Similarly, animals, we are also included in animals. They eat food and they produce energy for their daily activities, and this production of energy by food, which takes place in their body, is because of number of series of chemical reactions by which food is slowly converted to energy which is required for their activities. Like we have to move our fingers, we need some energy. And chemistry is also intimately involved in the air we breathe and the reason why we need air to breathe it, as air is a mixture of nitrogen, oxygen, argon, xenon. These are some few components, hydrogen and carbon dioxide. So the oxygen we require for our respiration, which is a chemical element or molecule. Similarly, with the help of chemistry, we can purify water for our drinking purposes. Almost every household now has a RO in their home, which has been built because of the knowledge of chemistry. Similarly, cooking. We all cook food, and cooking is also a series of chemical reactions by which the food is cooked and we eat it. And most importantly, chemistry has helped us in discovery and production of medicines to help maintain our health. This is the most important application of chemistry. And thousands of chemical reactions, they are happening in our own bodies all the time, like digestion, seeing with our eyes. This is also a result of a chemical reaction. Feeling with our fingers, growing, getting old. Each of these involves many chemical processes. As you are reading these words, your eyes are using an organic compound called retinal, which is a chemical compound. टू कन्वर्ट विजिबल लाइट इनटू नर्व इंपल्सेस व्हिच इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल टू बीइंग एबल अस टू सी द थिंग्स. सो केमिस्ट्री इज एवरीवेयर. वेयर एवर इज मैटर देयर इज ए केमिस्ट्री इन्वॉल्वड इन इट. सो एज लर्नड ए नॉलेज ऑफ केमिस्ट्री इज यूजफुल टू ऑलमोस्ट एवरीवन एज केमिस्ट्री अकर्स ऑल अराउंड अस ऑल ऑफ द टाइम एंड केमिस्ट्री हेल्प्स अस टू प्रोड्यूस न्यू मटेरियल्स दैट मेक अवर लाइव्स safer and easier. It can be used to produce new sources of energy that are abundant. Abundant means they are renewable and they are non-polluting, means safer for the environment, like biofuels. Chemistry also helps us to understand and control the many diseases that threaten us, and it is also useful in transforming matter into different forms with useful properties. So with the help of chemistry we can prepare a number of molecules or matter or compound with desired properties, like superconductors, semiconductors. These are some examples. And knowledge and understanding of chemistry, they are crucial in biology, pharmacology, medicine, geology, material science, many branches of engineering and other sciences. So these are some few examples in which, in order to understand even these subjects, biology, pharmacology, we have to understand chemistry first, as chemistry is involved everywhere. So considering this, I have presented some examples in which chemistry, knowledge of chemistry has helped us. First of all, it has helped us to establish chemical industries, which include petrochemical industries, polymer industries, paints, vanishes. Like petrochemical industries, they have given us gasoline, diesel, kerosene. So food industry, like flavors, artificial flavors, and cosmetics, these are all involved in chemical industry, and this industry has been set up because of knowledge of chemistry. Knowledge of chemistry has also helped in agriculture, where with the help of knowledge on chemistry we have been able to produce fertilizers, pesticides, insecticides. These are few examples which have helped in agriculture to increase the yield of crop and quality of crops. Next, knowledge of chemistry has resulted in medicines. So almost every household has in their home aspirin and paracetamol. These are very common medicines that you can get in every household, and these are chemical compounds. So these have been synthesized with the knowledge of chemistry. Similarly, cisplatin, which is used in chemotherapy to treat cancer. Taxol, this is also used in treatment of cancer. So with the help of chemistry, we have been able to synthesize artificial drugs, as well as we have been able to extract the drugs from our natural resources like plants, etc., herbal plants. So we have extracted medicines with the help of chemistry, knowledge of chemistry. It has also helped us to conserve the environment. With the knowledge of chemistry, we have been able to understand the reasons behind various pollutions, like soil pollution, water pollution, air pollution, and in order to remedify it, chemistry has helped us to conserve the environment. Next, it has helped us to synthesize specialized materials like, as I earlier mentioned, semiconductors. Now, in solar cells, semiconductors are used. Superconductors, we have been able to synthesize specialized polymers like polyethylene, polypropylene, bakelite, polyvinyl chloride, PVC. So these are common polymers. We have been able to synthesize various petrochemicals like gasoline, diesel, kerosene, etc. So these are some examples of specialized materials. Now that we have, with the help of chemistry, we have been able to synthesize new materials with high strength and durability, and they have lesser weight, which has helped us in space research programs to synthesize our rockets with specialized materials. Next, this knowledge of chemistry has helped in food and healthcare sector also. In healthcare sector, we can say there are very cosmetics. They are also a chemical compounds. With the help of chemistry, we have been able to synthesize various cosmetics. In food industry, we have synthesized various preservatives by which we can store food for the longer time. We have been able to synthesize artificial flavors, etc. So these are some few examples by in which chemistry has helped us. Next, it has also helped us in weather patterns. So these are just few examples that I have given. Instead of these, there are also many other fields in which chemistry has its applications, or we can say that we require a knowledge of chemistry to understand these things better. So we can say chemistry, knowledge of chemistry has helped us or has eased our life. It has been, with the help of chemistry, we have been able to generate air conditioners, refrigerators, vehicles, so which have made our life easier. Also, in our daily life, we came across so many phenomena, and it came to our minds that what is the reason behind these phenomena. So we can answer these phenomena or answer those questions which came to our mind with the help of knowledge on chemistry. So I have given here some of few questions that from our daily life it came to our minds, and if you know chemistry, you can answer these questions. Some of these questions are like, why does a metal get red hot and then white hot when it is heated? Why does rain fall as drops instead of cubes or cylinders? Why does salt help to clear snow and ice from the roads? What is the difference between saturated fat, unsaturated fat, and polyunsaturated fat? So nowadays, whenever you buy any product, eatable product, so its analysis is given. So it says it contains saturated fat. So what is that? What is unsaturated fat? What is polyunsaturated fat? So we can learn this with the help of chemistry. Where does the energy come from to make our muscles work? Like if we are moving, so we need some energy to do any process. So from where this energy comes? This can be answered with the knowledge of chemistry. So what are the molecules in my eyes doing when I watch a movie? Next question, why is the sky blue? We all see sky is blue. So what is the reason behind that? Why can some insects walk on water? Why is stratospheric ozone depletion harmful? So what will happen if there will be no ozone in our atmosphere? How does soap help to get clothes clean? So in our every household, soap or detergent is used to clean the clothes. So how does it clean the clothes? What is the mechanism behind that? What happens to an egg when I cook it? How are plastics made? And why are there so many different kinds? So plastics, they have changed our life. Now everywhere plastic has its use, from polythene to bakelite to specialized to our pet bottles. Everywhere there are polymers, or we can say plastics. So how are these made? Why is iron strongly attracted to a magnet, but most substances are not? This again we can answer with the help of chemistry. So why dry ice always surrounded by a fog? Dry ice is solid carbon dioxide. How do fireworks display so many colors on Diwali? So you might have seen on Diwali so many fireworks in the sky. They produce different colors, different patterns. How do they work? So this can be answered with the help of knowledge on chemistry. So why ice floats in glass of water? Even though ice is solid, it should dip in the water, but it floats. Why? What is the reason behind that? So that can be answered if we know, have fundamental knowledge about chemistry. So even though we don't have to choose chemistry as our career, but in order to understand other subjects, or in order to give answers to various such type of questions that occur in our daily life, a knowledge of chemistry is highly essential to us. So how the battery works to start your car or run your calculator? So start your car, we need battery. So calculators, they need battery. So how battery is generated and how does it works? We can answer this with the help of chemistry. So when we will complete our syllabus of chemistry, class 11, class 12, so you will be able to answer all these questions, and in our lecture we will try to give these answers to these questions. So I hope now you have come to know that how important is chemistry to us. So it will not be overstatement if I say where there is a matter, there is a chemistry involved with it. So in order to understand science, or in order to understand how different phenomena occur, we must learn chemistry. So this was the very basic lecture in which we defined chemistry and see how important it is to us. In our next lecture, we will learn about matter. As I said, chemistry is science of matter. So what is matter? And what are its properties? That we will see in our next lecture. So if you like the lecture, please do subscribe my channel and also share with your friends. Thank you very much.